Welcome to this first webinar on Mendix Magic. We will do a little demo today of Mendix based on a filtering solution on a helper function. And I came by this request via the forum where someone needed some help. And of course, I'm always willing to help around when needed. This forum link can be found here, although it's not really needed. And basically, the question was if I have two parts in a one-to-many relation, order and order item, if I filter on, for example, order and I get a smaller list of orders, I want to see also all the order items that are on that list. Easier said than done, I think, but also in line with philosophy of Mendix or Mendix Magic is that we are not only talking about solutions but also doing the solutions. So for that, I basically created a simple order item solution where you can easily see how I think a helper function should be implemented. So first, I start with the more standard solution of order and order items. I have a pretty simple domain model where you see the orders, the order items, and there's a client. So the client I will use for filtering. And I've basically also put in some data on this with three clients. Six or seven orders and a couple of order lines for each order. This is done all with standard Mendix without any special things or any items that are really making it more complex. So I'm going to view the application first. Basically, I have a simple standard filtering mechanism. And I have a tab with the options to do some crude activities like create, read, and change and delete items. So basically, there are three clients, five orders, and a couple of order items. In the regular screen, you can see the orders, they are sorted most recent first. And then below and in the left part or the right part you see your order items if you select one of the orders and you see the order items with it. So the question is if I filter on client A, then I only want to see all the order items for client A instead of having to click through all the individual orders. My suggestion, and that's what I want to show, is to implement a helper function with a new entity called a helper entity. I will make it non-persistent, and the only thing that will be in that function is a link to the client. So, not really anything special, but quite an easy and quick to manage solution. I'm going to save the domain model. I also will add a folder to store all the helper stuff. And first of all, you have, of course, the need to get a helper function. In this case, I will do a standard get create. Which basically currently will be only a create, but that doesn't really make any difference. So I do a retrieve, not a retrieve, I have to, of course, do a create object. You will see it's live in that sense that I will do some mistakes somewhere, but that's basically just to show how the system works. I do not put anything in it yet, so it's still empty. And I go back to my main screen. And I will add a tab where I will put in the helper filtering. So the helper filtering basically is a data view based on the just created get function, and I want to get it via a microflow. So the easy way is to do it somewhere like this, but of course I have to return an object if you want to use it as a data view object. And of course I have to return the helper, and I have to return the new helper one. I assume that you have some knowledge of Mendix, so that I don't have to explain all the nitty-gritty details. First I start with a reference selector where someone can select the client based on its name, and then I will start picking up the data or the structure from the earlier normal filtering screen. But now the real change will start. First of all, I will start using not the database, but will select a microflow, for example the DS DS order by helper or something like that. I don't want to fill it automatically, and I will go to that data get item, and of course it is as I have designed it within a data view of an helper, it will get the helper as a parameter. And there we start. For example, we say, and I do it the very nice way, it might be easier, but maybe this is more of a explanatory path to follow. So first of all, I'm going to get the client from the helper. I'm going to check if the client is found. Client is not empty, and if it's found, you have to do a retrieval of all orders of that client. And of course we will use this in a data grid, so we have to return a list of orders. In the order list. So that's the easy way. Client invalid, of course you have to put in the true, and the next step will be if the client is not found, then we basically will retrieve all orders like we did before, all orders from the database, order list full. Let's put some names in, and let's put it in here, order list filtered, so we know what we return. This part of the program needs an order list as well. So the full list is returned here. So basically we now have a helper function filled with parameters from the helper. I've not put in any ordering, etc., to show you the difference. Let's do a first trial on this item so that we can see what's going on. I'm going to remove this part of the screen just to see whether the filtering works on the order side. And I assume it will work, but it's never too late to do a test on it. So the system is now running or starting, and I will do a view. Of course it's again started in the browser, and I can select here client A, but you don't see that the filtering is working. This is the due to the fact that this refresh only will take place if the helper data is refreshed in screen. So on change, you basically have to say save changes. Do not close the page, because then you will go back to the home page. And now if we run it, it will work. Because then you will see that only client A is selected. So again, we do a view. If client A is selected, only the orders of client A are selected, client B and client C. So if you make it empty again, that works fine. So that's the first step. Then we go to the next step, and that's basically doing the filtering on the order items. Same procedure. Instead of going to the database, I'm going to use a microflow again. And here it will be something like DS order item by helper. Again, show it in here. We'll use the same structure. Like, so first I'm going to retrieve. Do a retrieve of the client again from the helper. Put in a decision again. And of course, I could have copied, etc. Client found. Client is not empty. That's one thing I've got to get used to, is that not equal is not greater than and smaller than, but is a equal to sign with a I don't know how you call it in English, but that's at least how it's done. Client found, condition is true. And again, here we are going to do a retrieve. And instead of doing a retrieve, I go to client, client order, order, order item. And I'm going to select all the order item lists. And again, this is the filtered order items, and in general, I'm going to put in a next activity, a new one. Let's put in some nice, and here the client is not found, so basically we are going to retrieve the order items. And this time I'm going to do not going to do a select by association, I'm going to do a direct database retrieve of all the order items. And here again, I will put in a end event, and also this will generate a list of order items. And here it will do the order items filtered. So this in general should be working. And just let's see how it works. There's still a visibility item in that I will remove just for now. That might be useful later on, but in general, if we now start the application, it will only show the order items of the client selected, and if no client is selected, it will show all the order items. So basically, it will, if you select client B, it's only selecting one item. If you select client A, it will give you all the order items. Well, this works like a charm, but I think there's something missing. And the thing that's missing is that if you select a specific order on this side, it should only show the orders on that side. one way of doing it is by getting back to the client, to the helper, also the client or the order ID. So I go back to the domain model. I basically put in a link to the order, and we'll put some logic in here, where if the on a single selection, there will be a default button, and I will call that button select order, and it will call a microflow act order select. Function. I was expecting here that it then also would come back with a object order from the list, and basically I will change the object of the helper function, where I will include and refresh also the order to the order that is passed as a parameter, that at least would show, and I will do it in steps. I want to add in here as well a little split container, or a 50-50 container, whatever you want to call it, and put in the reference selector for the order, so that we can see that the order is updated. Although we haven't done anything on the filtering yet. So basically I just want to make this a read-only, so that you're not going to change the order there. I'm going to run and see that I have some errors. Unfortunately, of course, what is the error in here? Oh, I will check. That's funny. Why can't I put in a this is the default button, then it works fine. So funny thing is that you have to define this as the default button. It will not show, but if you click on one of the lines, you will see the order line, or the order coming in here. I haven't changed anything on the filtering, so that will still work as we wanted. After we have selected the order, we have to adjust the filtering in the two filter programs, or filter microflows. Let's wait and see how this works. So first of all, I'm going to select a client, and then from client A, I will select order 2. And there's still a double tap on it. Well, I thought I defined it as single tap, but that does work. But what now the weird thing is, as you can do it in two ways. Basically, you say you do double click and say a single selection in here, and do a run. So basically you can see that now the order is passed on to this part of the screen. I can even filter on B. But now you see the behavior that if you select a client in here, the order might be wrong in here. So That's also one thing we have to change. At the moment we change the client in here, we have to clear the order ID. So I'm going to call a microflow act helper change client. Client change, maybe that's better. And in here I'm just doing a easy change of an object, like in the helper function. I'm going to change and refresh the order to empty. So in any case you are going to change the client, the order will be emptied and you will see all orders. So that's first step, but now the filtering is still not working. But first, let's see how this works. Interesting times. Just do a quick view, close all the other stuff. I'm going to select client A, then say I want to see order 2, client B, and then it's empty again. So that's now working fine. And now the only thing I have to do is do some additional steps in the filtering, where we will say in the order filtering, I will do first a retrieve of the order link to the helper. And of course, again, a decision order found. Order is not empty. In case it is found, we are not going through with the rest. In case it's found, we are going not to do another retrieve because we already have retrieved the order. I'm going to do a create list. And in the create list, I just create the list with orders and I call that the order list. And here I'm going to add a record to the order list. Order, and then my order list is returned to the grid. You have to do this create list because you have to return a list. Returning an object will result in an error, but this will work. Now to be a little bit more quick, I will do this piece again in here, paste in the same logic. Based in a start event, and again this will be done in the false case, and in the true case I'm going to do a retrieve. So now I'm going to retrieve all the order items from the specific order and we'll return that one to the grid order item list, and hopefully that will work. Proof of the pudding is in the eating, so let's start on seeing that this is giving me the results I want. Basically, I'm just going to say I only want to see A, and then you only see the orders related to A. If you select an order here, you only see the items from order 2. If you want to go back to client A or B and then go back to A, then you will get all the refreshes done, etc. So basically, and you can expand this helper, of course, with dates, whatever you like. If you want to change the sorting, because that's one of the downsides of Mendix, you cannot order if you base your thing on a microflow. You have to do the sorting in the microflow itself. So for example, here we can say we are going to retrieve the list, but if you do it via a list here, then we have to do a list operation, and that will be a sort, and then we are going to do a filtered list and we sort it on order date descending. But then we also have to do the new order list. We have to give that through. The other option you will have is not to do it here, but change this into a retrieve from database, where you will say, I'm going to retrieve all the orders from a client. And this is my preferred solution. And say, I want to have the ordering here. You don't have to do extra lists. You don't have to do extra things. Here you already have the list from the data, so yeah, it's quite a straightforward change. And here you basically have just one list, so you don't have to do any ordering. The same can be done, of course, in the helper order items. I don't know what, where, if you want to order here on, again, order date descending, then that might be a useful thing. And again, do it on all orders, order date, and of course here we have to change it into a database retrieval. Order item, and order date descending. Rerun. Oh, project cannot be deployed. Undefined new order list. Yeah, of course, I've removed the object or the list operation. So again, we have the sorting differently in here, and the sorting in here also, although I think this is not working always. So let's see what happens. If I select client A, then it works. So if you have no filtering, then the ordering is not correctly set. Order date descending. Order date descending. Let's look at order item. Descending. And I think I forgot here to put in that it is a descending ordering. So this is much of the demo I want to give on how to filter based on a helper function. I hope this will help anyone, specifically the one who made the forum request. And yeah, this is quite a nice solution, I think. And of course, yeah, you can expand, or you can even do some buttons in here where you say, okay, I want to clean up, or I want to do some extra things. Thanks for having a look at the demo. Be aware, I will do more publications in the coming weeks. Don't forget to visit my website and the portal. The portal is located, and I will show you on my screen. It's a free app location. Hopefully you will find time to visit it one time and see some more tricks. This movie will be available in the movie part of the website, and that will be a fun sight to see. Thanks for your attention, and we keep in touch. Bye bye.